proudly brought to you by Hovertech. Hovertech, just a button away.
In this video tutorial, I'll be explaining how to backup and restore NVRAM to a Spreadtrum Android device using NCK Box Spreadtrum Module. First off, you need to have the NCK Pro Box hardware. I need to have set it up. I have a guide for that. You also need to have installed the Spreadtrum USB drivers. We also have a guide for that. And of course, you need to have the Spreadtrum phone which you want to backup NVRAM from or restore to. And just in case you don't know what the NVRAM is for, NVRAM controls your phone's radio, such as some things like your IMEI, your Bluetooth address, Wi-Fi address, and the rest. So if you have an NVRAM problem, your phone might not be able to detect SIM card due to the invalid IMEI, or you might have Bluetooth or Wi-Fi problems. So in such a case, you need to back up the NVRAM from a working phone and rewrite to yours. And that is what this guide is about. Now, once you have this in place, you need to also have installed the NCK Box Spreadtrum module, as I have here, and run as administrator. We have a guide on how to install the Spreadtrum module for NCK Box, so ensure to check out that guide and download the module. Now, what you want to do is just to wait for the module's dashboard to come up, and of course, the box needs to be connected to the PC, but not the phone yet. Alright, great. So the dashboard is up. Now what you want to do is to come under the Flash Mode Utils, although you can also do the same thing under the Diag Mode, but that will be in another tutorial. This tutorial is about the Flash Mode. Now what you want to do is come under the Flash Mode tab and you select your phone's CPU. Now we have a guide on how to find out your phone's chipset, so make sure you follow that guide. Now for this particular phone I'm using is a generic CPU, so I'll just select generic here. Actually an Innjoo phone, Innjoo Halo, so I'll just select generic there. And then for the chipset, this is what the phone's chipset is. So under this job section, what I want to do is to select backup NVRAM. So I'm backing up from the working phone in this case. Although it's the very same phone I'm backing up and writing to in this tutorial, but just to show you what it's going to be like. Now, so we are backing up the NVRAM first, and we have the working phone standing by. So what we want to do is to select this option that I have here, and then you click on Do Job. Now, at this point, what we want to do is to power off the Spreadtrum device, still with battery in, then you hold the volume down button. All right, then connect it to the PC via the USB cord. Now for this particular phone I'm using is actually the volume up button. It's a very weird phone, so everything is the other way around for this phone. Okay, so I have USB not recognized. I'm going to have to abort, and then when you have something like this, you have to just take out and reinsert the battery. Okay, that's what you do, and make sure you are holding the volume button correctly and not pressing both. So I've taken out and reinserted the battery. I'm going to repeat the procedure, and I'm connecting now. Still seem to be running into this. Alright, so what I can do now is to just close this box. I close the tool. I eject the smart card, that is the box, I reinsert, then I'm going to rerun the tool. Well, I could as well cut out this part from the guide, but very important to you also see what I'm encountering, so you know what to do when you're in a similar situation. So I've taken out and inserted the phone's battery. That didn't seem to help. Next up, I've close the tool, I've disconnected and reconnected the box, and I'm relaunching the NCK Pro. I'm relaunching the NCK Spreadtrum module. Alright, so I have it up. I come here, I come under generic. Here, this is the phone's CPU, and then I back up NVRAM. Do job. Alright, holding the volume up button, it's supposed to be volume down, but this particular phone is actually the other way around. Okay, great, it's working this time around. For most Spreadtrum phones, it's the volume down button. But you see, for this particular phone, it's actually the opposite. Everything is the opposite. The volume up button instead. So if you find that the volume down button doesn't seem to be helping the two connect, then use the volume up button. All right, great. So my backup is complete. I have done. I can disconnect the phone. I can just remove and reinsert the battery. All right. So now what you want to do is navigate to this directory where you have the NVRAM backup. Your NVRAM contains a number of partitions actually. So I will just go down to my NCK box, backup, SPD NVRAM backup. All right, great. So I have my backup here. All right. So now to restore, it's the same procedure. We are restoring to the bricked phone. That is the phone that has an NVRAM issue. So what you just want to do is to launch the tool as I earlier described. You select the phone's chipsets. Everything is still the same in this case. But under the job, we'll be selecting restore NVRAM and then do job. All right. So what you want to do is navigate to location where you have the NVRAM file that is in the bin format. You select the file and then you open. Now what you want to do is to power up the device still with battery in it. You hold the volume down button ideally, but if in your case it's the other way around like this phone, you hold the volume up. All right, so I have my NVRAM being written now to the phone which has NVRAM issues. So prod NV, that is being written back. All right, great. So that is done. So now you can now boot up the phone and you see that the NVRAM issue should have been resolved. So that's how to back up and write NVRAM to a Spreadtrum Android device using NCK Box Spreadtrum Module.